I hope yesterday in your AS12, a lot of your queries must have been resolved, because in government grants, because the major confusion was always related to the grants, how the grants should be treated, etc. So I hope Anand must have clarified a lot of your points. If you ask me, this session, which I'm taking it today, should be the last one. Because it's like a summary of all the sessions. Because here we are discussing the first step, step number two, step number three, step number four. When you go back and you discuss with your seniors that yes, we have realized this, these are the good effects, these are the bad effects, pros and cons. And this is the first step we should take it to implement the system in our organization. But as I was asked to take this session, so I'm taking it right now, and I've tried to cover up everything which is possible in the last 2 or 3 days discussion. And I'm telling you, it just I have prepared from my mind. All of you are most welcome to please add or delete something to the slide. This is a very, very different, no technical here, no theoretical here. It's just a practical ground reality from my experience. If you start preparing the system, what is the first step, step two, step three? And if you ask me the title which has been given in your workshop schedule, from cash to accrual, I have changed it, if you see. Because when I was going through the annual report, I think accrual accounting, most of you are doing it. You already are charging depreciation. You are already putting the fee receivable entry. You are already charging the interest deposit entry, accrual entry. So accrual is already there. At least in most of the organization it is there. I agree, there can be some organizations in which it is not. That's the reason I have changed from cash to accrual implementation of accounting standards here. Because if I say AS, automatically, as per AS1, accrual accounting gets mandatory. So in a way, wo cash to accrual apne aap hi usme cover ho jata hai. So if you ask me, I'll be dealing with, these are the simple 4 points, nothing else. And I'll be going very, very slow. It's not huge presentation. And I'm telling you, not even a single point you will find any of the book. It's all from the mind, from the experience. Because logically, at present, in the last 2-3 days when we were discussing, there were a lot of discussions, sir, if we implement this, and the first problem which will arise is statutory auditor. They still don't agree about the new format. Yesterday, I was going through in detail about the new format. Frankly speaking, there is no change in the new format. It just, they have given it more segmental reporting in a way. They have given unrestricted, restricted separately. So, koi khas ya koi major change nahi hai. Agar aap dekhe, depreciation ka unhone ek alag se head de diya hai. They are asking you to prepare schedules for everything. So, in a way, whatever you were preparing it exactly, wohi hai. And I'm not sure whether you guys have the new format prepared by ICI as a sample format or not. How many of you have that? ICI ne ek sample format banake diya tha Excel mein. How many of you don't have it? I'll be uploading even that format also to the site. When we had the first workshop in Delhi, I still remember, ICI has prepared the full training material that Mr. Shyam was referring to it. Along with that format, ICI has also prepared one Excel sheet of a sample format. Usme even figures bhi di hui hai. There is also one Word file in which they have compared your old format with a new format. If you don't have it, take it from me. Take it from sir. That will really help you. Because today's session may last for 1 hour, for 2 hours, but it is exactly related to in next 2 or 3 years, I should say, I'm not talking about 1 year, because frankly speaking, 13, 14 has gone. In our way, it has gone. So we are looking at it, ki let's suppose in 2, 3 years, agar mujhe implement karna hai, toh kaise karna hai? First, or of course, there will be challenges, pre-implementation. Pre means before implementation. Logically, when we were discussing in last 2 days, first was statute auditor, second point was some already ground reality problems. How to deal with this transaction, how to deal with the CPWD approval, how to deal with the grants, how to deal with the temporary structures, how to pass the entries for some transactions. It means these are the issues which you face on day-to-day basis in real life. Logically, uska ek solution hame nikalna hai. Kyunki is session ka sirf ek purpose hai. Koi theoretical nahi hai, koi AS nahi hai isme. Ki agar mujhe start karna hai, to ground reality mein, mere ko kya kya solutions nikalne hai. After, of course, first we'll identify those challenges. And then we all together will try to find out the solutions. Shayad meri itni knowledge nahi hogi, because you guys are working in the ground reality. Bakshi sir is here. So at least it's a good platform for us, whereby we can convey through this presentation to him, these are the points which you should keep it in mind before implementation. And this presentation, we'll give it to him, and now he has to take it forward to the ministry to find out the solutions. And I have always remember one thing, generally in our CA profession it is said, CA clear karna is tough, but after becoming a CA, your actual challenge starts. Because before CA, before you are not CA, at least you can ask as number of doubts. But once you become a CA, and still if you say, what is the entry of this transaction, then logically your boss will say, sorry, you're not a good CA. Same here, you can ask as number of things before implementation. But once a system gets implemented, then I'm telling you the expectation of your management, of ministry, of statutory auditor will be at this level. So, aaj, like a student, you can ask as number of things in next 2 years, 3 years. But ek baar system implement ho jata hai na, then you cannot say, sorry, isme ye loophole hai, isme ye nahi hai. Aaj time hai, jitna aapne kehna hai, whatever you want to put it, do it. It's an open Pandora box I'm opening. Open Pandora box. Then logically, what we achieve if we implement this? Only these 4 points, nothing else. So first, I'll talk about challenges. I have divided into in this. Correct me where I'm wrong. It's just from my experience I prepared it. These are the, do you expect that this reform can be done only by MHRD, only by ICI, or only by you guys? Do you need a joint effort or not? Yes or no? Because in today's, I will not speak. I want the inputs from you guys, because a lot of senior people are here, and you can tell me, ki sir, isme ye cheeze honi chahiye. It means we need a coordinated effort. Agreed or no? Everyone, right? From MHRD, we are looking at 2 expectations. One at the ministry level. One at the top level, ki aapko kya karna hai. And one, we are looking at the institutional level. From the organization perspective, MHRD ko kya kya karna hai ministry level pe, aur each organization's ke level pe. Agreed? Ye inki responsibility honi chahiye. Theek hai? If I talk about the first part. First thing, they will have to at least get C&AG on the board. Board in a sense, at least on one line. Otherwise, I know I have been a part of accounting also. I have been a part of auditor also. So I know being an accountant is always a tough task. Being an auditor is in a way easy, because you are reviewing the work. Reviewer is always at a better position. So, jab tak ek common platform nahi aayega, wo ek dar accountant ke man mein hamesha rehta hai. Jab maine bhi accounting kari thi, I was always under one fear, I don't know what happens. If auditor comes, whether he will take out one comment, two comments, three comments, maybe 10 comments. It's always there. So first thing, it is not from you, your side, not from ICI side, this is from the MHRD side. First point, do you agree or not? In today, I want yes or no. Everyone? Right. So that's the first task. And we will also try to set a timeline for each. जब timeline set हो जाएगा तो automatically एक responsibility आती है. Timeline आपके लिए भी होगा, सर के लिए भी होगा. अगर मैं ICI को represent कर रहा हूँ तो हमारे लिए भी है. Second, this I'll discuss in detail. This is very, very important, I'm telling you. Because for schools, colleges, universities, at each level, there are different problems. किसी की transactions की problem है, किसी का depreciation का problem है, किसी का management की approval से problem है, किसी का software issue है. So in all these things, there should always be one ready document, जिसको generally हम लोग real life में कहते हैं CGD, Comprehensive Guidance Document, which can provide you step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4, step 5. कि अगर मुझे कहीं भी problem आता है, I can immediately refer it. जैसे at present, we refer GFR. Isn't it? It means operational manual should be in line with GFR as per the new format. So this document has to be in place. जब तक ये document नहीं आएगा, each one of us will keep on doing as per our own mind. I'm telling you, sir, वो consistency कभी नहीं आ सकता. Because ground reality में problem आपको face करनी है. And you have to immediately find a solution. And if you do not have a document, तो logically आप अपने experience से जाएंगे. And in that experience, you might be thinking it's right, but maybe statutory auditor, maybe MHRD may feel it's wrong. So if a document comes from MHRD, then logically, things are in place. I take example why I have raised this point. Because if you remember my first session, first 5 minutes, I started with this. It is exactly same reforms which came 15 years earlier at the government level, local government level. Even at the local government level, what they have done, they have prepared a state manual. First they prepared a national manual. National means country level. But then they realized it, that each state has their own problems, own revenue structures. They then have prepared each state manual. Or state ka matlab hota hai, it's approval from the state government. And if it is approved from the state government, then logically local government has to follow it. Now each and every state has that manual. So whenever any problem arises, they immediately refer to that state manual. Exactly here we can have it. We even can have it. Now you tell me, I'm just putting in front of you. Should this be centralized or it can be of three level? For university separate, for school separate, and for colleges separate. Is there a major difference? So we can have, sir, three tiers also. Tier 1, tier 2, tier 3 also. One we can have a centralized. And then we can have a separate volumes for schools, colleges, jo variations hai. Jo common hai, we can prepare a common document. And a separate, we can have a separate part. So that if you are working for university, then you don't need to refer to school one. If I'm working for school level, there is no need to refer to the university level. Agreed, sir? Because CBSE mein shayad school ka jyada aata hai.
There can be only one manual.
Okay.
It can incorporate various chapters.
सर वो आएगा, वो भी आएगा, उसमें सर इश्यू प्रॉब्लम भी आता है, आप भी एग्री करेंगे.
60-70%
व्हाट वी कैन हैव, वी कैन हैव अ वन कॉमन वॉल्यूम एंड वन सेपरेट वॉल्यूम. उसमें सर बेनिफिट प्रॉब्लम क्या आती है, एज अ स्टूडेंट आई एम सीइंग, जब एक वॉल्यूम होता है ना सर, और उसमें यूनिवर्सिटी का भी होता है, कॉलेज का भी होगा, स्कूल का भी होगा, वी फील ओ इट्स अ वेरी थिक डॉक्यूमेंट, वेरी थिक, वी डोंट रीड इट. आई एम टेलिंग यू, I still remember when I started my CA, I purchased my first book of RL Gupta accounts. It was like this. My mother told me, Pankaj, what are you doing? I said, this is a CA and this is inter level. And I did not start it with the first page. I started with the last page. How many pages it has it? And as a normal student, we generally, whenever a document is given, we always see the thickness of it. In how many days we'll complete it. And we all are being governed by our seniors. A senior will say, this document has come from ministry, please read it, make a synopsis, and tell to me. I'm telling you that. I'm talking about the real life reality. Ye hota hai. I am sitting in the ministry daily basis by joint secretary, give us some document, Pankaj, read this, and in the evening, make a presentation for 5 minutes. They expect 100 pages document to give a presentation in 5 minutes. So we have to make it. That's the real life scenario I'm talking about. So it means the operational manual required. So we agree here, one common and one at separate levels. Agreed, everyone? Because at the last, I'll be typing in front of you the 5 or 6 bullets, which will be given to sir. बिल्कुल सर सर कॉमन मैनुअल में जो कॉमन चीजें हैं लाइक डेप्रिसिएशन के रेट्स राइट लेट सपोज फॉर्मेट्स वो तो कॉमन रहेगा ना सर सिर्फ ट्रांजैक्शंस कैन बी डिफरेंट सर जैसे मे बी यूनिवर्सिटी लेवल पे ट्रांजैक्शन कुछ अलग हो सकती हैं कॉलेजेस लेवल पे ट्रांजैक्शन अलग होंगी फॉर एग्जाम्पल स्कूल लेवल पे नर्सरी प्राइमरी एवरीवन इज देयर और उस पर फीस आती है क्वार्टरली बट जनरली कॉलेजेस में सर फीस आप सबको पता है एक बार आती है एनुअल में बिल्कुल सर सर वो व्हेन दिस मैनुअल विल बी प्रिपेयर्ड दे विल इट इज अ कंसल्टेटिव प्रोसेस इट इज नॉट दैट दे विल प्रिपेयर इट दे नीड द कंसल्टेशन फ्रॉम यू गाइस इफ लेट्स सपोज आई हैव बीन हायर्ड दीज मैनुअल आर नेवर प्रिपेयर्ड बाय मिनिस्ट्री इट इज ऑलवेज प्रिपेयर्ड बाय द एक्सटर्नल एजेंसी इज हायर्ड दे विल कम टू यू
मैनुअल जो प्रिपेयर किया जाएगा ना जो मिनिस्ट्री ने या किसी ने जो गाइडलाइन इशू की है उसके बेस पे ही प्रिपेयर किया जाएगा
बिल्कुल सर
तो उसके लिए जो कॉमन बनेगा तो वो जैसे अगर कॉमन बनाएंगे तो सभी के वो रूल जो वो उसमें इनकॉर्पोरेट हो जाएंगे तो कई बार उसको रेफर करने में प्रॉब्लम आएगी अगर जो छोटे मैनुअल होंगे तो उसको स्टडी जल्दी किया जा सकता है
अगर छोटे छोटे होते
छोटा मतलब इंस्टीट्यूट लेवल का जो मैनुअल होगा ना जैसे सेंट्रल इंस्टीट्यूट का अलग होगा उसका
अच्छा यू आर सेइंग कि यूनिवर्सिटी का अलग ओके कैन बी कोई बात नहीं सर उसमें कोई इशू नहीं है
हमें इसको इजी वे में देखना चाहिए ना कि
परफेक्टली फाइन बताइए बख्शी साहब कैन बी पॉसिबिलिटी हम जस्ट पुटिंग अ सॉल्यूशन अभी लेट्स सी कितना इंप्लीमेंट होता है बिल्कुल सर वॉट अ कंसल्टेंट जनरली व्हेनेवर कंसल्टेंट इज आई एग्री विद यू सर ही विल ऑलवेज फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल सी टू व्हाट एक्सटेंट द वेरिएशंस आर देयर ही विल रेफर फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल योर एनुअल रिपोर्ट लेट्स सपोज एनुअल रिपोर्ट ऑफ स्कूल राइट मे बी द ऑटोनोमस बॉडीज लाइक आईएम्स आईआईटी मे बी कॉलेज सेपरेट स्कूल वो पहले रिपोर्ट देखेगा सबकी व्हेन आई रेड द रिपोर्ट फ्रैंकली स्पीकिंग इफ यू आस्क मी एज अ सीए 60% सेम इवन 70% सेम आई शुड से Like accounting policies are common almost, right? Format is a common format. There are only minor variations. So, wo, if you have a separate, can be separate, but guaranteed, sir, us separate may be 70% cheeze common milengi aapko. Which sir, usme koi consultant ko karna kya hota hai? Wo kya karega? Control A karega, control C karega, control V, but 70% common. उसमें कुछ नहीं करना है आई एम टेलिंग यू दैट ना वो कैन बी डन उसमें कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है आप उसकी वॉल्यूम्स बना लीजिए या आप उसको सेपरेट कर लीजिए एटलीस्ट 70% चीज़ें कॉमन ही होगा उसके डन सर यू पुट अ सजेशन एंड लेट्स सी नाउ यू टेल मी इज इट पॉसिबल टू इम्प्लीमेंट इन 1 month देयर हैज़ टू बी सम टाइम फ्रेम इट विल टेक एटलीस्ट 3 or 4 years सो आई हैव डिजाइंड सम टाइम फ्रेम विल कम टू दैट स्लाइड All these points will be discussed in detail also. Then we will add to each and every point, add or delete. But you agree that time frame has to be there? Because unless until time frame is there, sir, we never do anything. Jab time frame hoga, 100% hai, even MHRD will have the responsibility. IKAI will have the responsibility, and even from your side also, they will be responsible. Because please understand, it's not a one-man show. It's a joint show. It's not like a lawn tennis, where one player is playing it. It's like a cricket match, where everyone has to perform it. What about the next one? Because when I was discussing with most of you guys, everyone was saying, at least for starting 2 years, 3 years, we need some support from the external agency. Maybe ICI supports it. Someone has to be there who has a technical knowledge, who has experience in this. Otherwise, it's very, very difficult. Reason being, you guys are talented, expert, but the problem is you guys are already so busy in your work. Because at present, so theek hai, jab actually session start hota hai. I know I'm being a part of DU. There's a lot of pressure, especially in colleges in the month of July. In schools, generally March and April admission time, examination time, a lot of pressure. So, some reforms, etc., goes one side. But at least if you have one support, then and with a permission from MHRD, will it help or not?
Proper support university se nahi milta hai.
Okay, sir. In a way.
होता क्या है जो प्रैक्टिकल डिफिकल्टी होती है वो जो चाहते हैं उनके हिसाब से मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट है यूनिवर्सिटी में जो अकाउंट्स के लोग काम करते हैं उन्हें लगता है कि फालतू बकवास समय बर्बाद करने आ गए एक आदमी यूनिवर्सिटी में चाहिए जो ये समझ सके कि ये जो मांग रहे हैं हमारी भलाई के लिए है मेरे अच्छाई के लिए है इस बात को समझने वाला यूनिवर्सिटी में कोई नहीं रहता है इन जनरल मोस्ट ऑफ द यूनिवर्सिटीज़ में नॉन प्रोफेशनल लोग काम करते हैं
ओके
मोस्टली टीचर्स ही फाइनेंस ऑफिसर हैं ज़्यादा जगह
राइट
तो उन्हें इससे कोई मतलब नहीं कि यहाँ का अकाउंट्स खराब है अच्छा है चुल्ला भाड़ में जाए
ओके
तो उनका सपोर्ट जो है यूनिवर्सिटी के तरफ से वो एक्सटर्नल एजेंसी को उतना नहीं मिल पाता है
ओके
और बहुत जगह तो 2 महीने में बदल गए 4 महीने में बदल गए कहीं हैं कहीं नहीं हैं
ओके
और वैसी स्थिति में ये सारा एक्सरसाइज जीरो हो जाएगा
So you are saying support from the top?
Yes. Support from top और निश्चित रूप से वहाँ एक professional रहे
okay.
जो ये समझ सके कि ये external agency जो काम करने आया है it is one of the most important thing. Otherwise, उस काम को सबसे नीचे माना जाता है बेकार आके वो expert बैठा रहेगा सारा दिन बैठा रहेगा एक कागज उसको नहीं मिलेगा
I agree with it. It's a very common problem. You're right, sir. I have faced being a CA, we keep on sitting outside, right? I'll take an example. In Raipur, I went and joint secretary gave me the time. And he said at 9 o'clock. I was waiting outside, sitting on the chair, right? In the scorching heat in Raipur. And at 9 o'clock was appointment. He called me inside at 2 o'clock. I was waiting outside for 5 hours.
Because I have experience of 32 years. 4 years in HRD ministry, 18 to 20 years in urban local bodies, and in power sector, textile industry, paper industry, so many industries. And what I have felt, wherever there are professional experts working in the organization, their performance is very good. Where the professional is not working as a head or in the actual capacity, their performance is always very bad in spite of getting a lot of expert outside expert. तो वहाँ यूनिवर्सिटी में एक खास लेवल पे एक प्रोफेशनल एक्सपर्ट की बहुत आवश्यकता
ये सिर्फ यूनिवर्सिटी पे आ गए या सीबीएसई लेवल पे भी आता है सर ये
यस सर एक तरफ मिनिस्ट्री कहती है कि आप ऑटोनोमस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हैं लेकिन फाइनेंशियल मैटर में अगर हम अपने ऑर्डिनेंस में स्लाइटली भी चेंज करते हैं तो उसको वो रिजेक्ट कर देती है और कहती है फॉलो द GFR रूल इन केस आवर यूनिवर्सिटी हम लोगों ने 15,000 रुपया तक को से बढ़ा के 25,000 लोकल परचेज का किया था और जनरल परचेज और लोकल परचेज कमेटी के थ्रू 1 लाख से बढ़ा के 1.5 लाख का किया था मिनिस्ट्री ने डायरेक्टली इसको रिजेक्ट कर दिया और वो कहा फॉलो दी GFR रूल तो वेयर वी हैव गिवन द ऑटोनॉमी इन केस ऑफ फाइनेंशियल ईयर दैट शुड बी क्लियर फ्रॉम द मिनिस्ट्री वी शुड बी गिवन द ऑटोनॉमी
सर वो आई थिंक हमने फर्स्ट टाइम कर लिया कि सपोर्ट मिनिस्ट्री जाएगा वो आएगा
नहीं तो दैट शुड बी गिवन फॉर द फ्रॉम द मिनिस्ट्री कि वी शुड बी गिवन ऑटोनॉमी
सर आई थिंक ये पॉइंट इससे रिलेटेड नहीं है
नहीं
आई फील इन द एग्जिस्टिंग माइंडसेट इफ एट द बिगिनिंग ओनली वी टेक अ प्रोफेशनल एक्सटर्नल हेल्प देन वी विल नेवर लर्न सो इट्स इंपॉर्टेंट लाइक दिस मैन पावर रिसोर्स डेवलपमेंट वेयर वी लर्न टू इंप्लीमेंट वी मे हैव हिचेस वी हैव एक्सपर्ट्स लाइक यू टू गाइड अस but we learn, not with professional help. We are, I mean, in our interaction with here, we heard that some of the institutes have appointed CA to make the final accounts. So therefore, they have no headache to learn. They will do only the basic entries and give it to CA. So I think we need to develop our own manpower.
Ma'am, you are right, but there is always some drive is also there. Aisa nahi hai. It all depends upon the person also.
Actually, see, in the present day scenario, no, where you cannot have experts from all the fields in your institute or in your organization. So I worked in IIT Guwahati, now I am at NIT Meghalaya. So considering the resources available inside my organization, I have taken help from outside experts. So you'll have to go for that. That does not mean that we are not learning.
I'm not saying you're wrong. You're perfectly right. But the problem is, when in the starting, whenever there's some glitches are there, immediately when you are working already in the organization, you're so busy, sometimes that issue gets linger on. When you have already some agency, not sitting there, but at least when you have some support, let the presentation be over. I have even provided a solution also. At present, I'm just giving the challenges. Right? And I'm just hearing from you guys, these are the challenges and what solution we can have it. Because we are here for a group, right? Actually, not for a single school or university or college.
Definitely, we may not solely depend on the experts in here. We have to learn. But as the time goes by, we always have to take help from some external agencies or experts. Unless it will know. This is the year of the day now.
I'll take an example. If I remember correctly, sir ne ek point raise kiya tha 2 days earlier, that it is very tough for a physical verification. In that physical verification, let's suppose you may take a help, right? For a valuation of some assets, when you are not the engineer, you may take a help. It's not necessary for everything, but for some part where you feel that you need a help, you can have it. Yes, sir.
Sir, presently I am working at CBSE, but I have worked in other ministries also. Problem persists. It is there in almost all the organizations. The degree only varies. Mm-hmm. CBSE is a unique case because it doesn't receive the grants from the government of India. It's a self-sufficient body. That's why the problem is very meager in CBSE, because it is headed by academicians and it is headed by IAS presently. So they understand all the problems also. Wherever problems are there, either at my level or at the level of the chairman or secretary level, we resolve the issues. But in my earlier assignments, I had seen that accounts is certainly the kind of acceptance which it should get, it is not getting. Because some problems when we raise, then it takes a back seat only. Because issues which are raised are not the issues which are, you know, in front of all the scientific community or the other community which are sitting at the helm of affairs. They don't see it at a level which they ought to have seen it.
Sir, I agree. Finance is always taken only the figures, and they always, because finance mein tangible kuch nahi aata. So I agree, wo attitude har jagah hai.
Sir, usme kya hota hai? What we are assessed on a different platform.
Distinction between financial account, there is eager to do for further distribution. Financing is still taken care of.
Accounts is not, I know, accounts is never.
We are assessed by two standards. One, when we deal with on the front face, we make the payments, we entertain bills, we do all those things. Our expectation, people's expectation from us is that their payments should be released immediately and their things should be done, their files should be cleared. If Agreed. We do that, then we are a very good person. But in the back end, when we are to prepare the accounts, when we have to see the bank reconciliation statement, when we have to implement accounting, it is none of their business. They think it is the job of the accounts officer, and hardly any support
is there. I think let's not even expect that outside people will change the attitude.
Let me say one more thing. So when we hire the external agency, mm-hmm. the internal people, what they feel, ki, theek hai, external agency has come, but again, the work is to be done by the internal agency. The kind of support which is to be given to the external agency doesn't come. Because they see, they have come and set on our head actually. So that...
Sir, again, that's a attitudinal change.
That is correct. This is the problem. So what we do, the solution what we have found out, we have appointed nodal officer.
Okay.
That nodal officer, the external agency will deal with the nodal officer, and nodal officer will deal internally.
Okay.
Because he will be knowing all the sections, all the departments inside the organization or university or IIT or IIMs or any other organizations. So the nodal, the external agency will not deal with the individual staff. They will deal with the nodal officer, and nodal officer will deal with all the subjects and he will provide expected support to the agency so that whatever is expected, it comes in reality.
Okay, let's see.
Yes, sir.
Ma'am,
yes,
one.
Nodal officer also is from one of us only. From one of us, he may be deputy star,
basically,
star or...
Sir, ULBs mein hota hai, centralized person designate kar diya. Urban local bodies mein hi hota hai. Ek centralized person designate kiya, koi bhi bahar se aayega, pehle usse batayega. Phir training of trainer ka concept hai, taught. Then that nodal officer will tell to the finance officers, accounts people later. It's like training of trainers.
I think, sir, most of the university suffering by shortage of account staff, number one.
Okay.
So then, initially, there should be a external agency for starting this process.
Okay.
And I don't agree with nodal officer. Nodal officer should be either accounts officer or finance officer or whatsoever from the internal side of the university.
Okay.
It is extremely necessary for external agency for starting the this process.
Dhakka marne ke liye.
Yes. Then university itself will start this work in future.
Ma'am, please.
Yes, sir. The Northeastern Hill University had started this new format of accounting in 2006-07 with the wholehearted support of the consultant of NIFM.
Okay, good.
We have started.
Acha, Faridabad. NIFM Faridabad.
Yes, yes. But the point is, our finance officer, as per statute, is to be a member from the organized account service, or a CA, or a master's degree with 18 years or 16 years experience in financial administration. So we hardly get members from the organized account services nowadays. There's dearth of those. So neither CA applies. And though we could have one, the finance officer is a tenure post of 5 years. So 5 years, you know, you the sense of ownership, sense of belonging to the institute. Is you can understand, like regular employees, so we are regular employees, but we belong to general cadre.
I got it.
General cadre. We may be made to work in finance, we may be made to work in the personnel section.
I'll come to that point. Ma'am, I already note kara hua hai, because I know what happens generally. You are working in one organization, one department for 2 years, you learn something, then you're transferred. That point is already there. And we'll put all these points in solutions. You will be surprised, last one slide is blank. We'll fill it later. Sir.
Sir, हमारे जितने भी autonomous bodies हैं जो आज की date में जिनको ये professional मतलब आजकल के time में जितने भी ये transitional changes आ रही हैं switch over हो रहा है उतने हमारे पास expert staff नहीं है.
Right, sir.
मतलब even जो हमारे नीचे का staff है वो डेबिट क्रेडिट के बारे में अभी कुछ नहीं जानता
ये I agree.
और दूसरा जो है इवन जो एग्जीक्यूटिव लेवल्स में भी जो है वो जो कैडर है वो रिक्रूटमेंट रूल्स में फुली डिफाइंड नहीं है कि एटलीस्ट सम सीए आईसीडब्ल्यूए वगैरह ऐसी प्रोफेशनल डिग्री लेके तो आना चाहिए उनको एटलीस्ट सो दैट मतलब अगर कल को एक्सटर्नल एजेंसी भी जो अगर काम करे तो उनसे काम करवाने के लिए भी प्रॉपरली ताकि मिलजुल के एक कोऑर्डिनेटेड वे में प्रॉपरली काम हो तो ये एमएचआरडी की तरफ से भी एक जाना चाहिए कि फाइनेंस एंड अकाउंट्स कैडर कैसे स्ट्रॉन्ग मतलब हो सकता है ऑटोनोमस बॉडीज का सो दैट ये सारी चेंजेस को इंप्लीमेंट किया जा सके
राइट आई जस्ट एडिट हियर सर द प्रोजेक्ट व्हिच आई एम डूइंग फॉर द वर्ल्ड बैंक ना देयर वी हैव डन वन प्रोजेक्ट वन असाइनमेंट म्युनिसिपल कैडर फॉर 34 सिटीज राइट देयर इज वन External agency, they have seen the current cadre and how that cadre can be changed or reformed or modified. And they have suggested lot of changes in that. Exactly here, the finance and accounts cadre. Because generally what happens, with due respect to everyone, even I've been a part of DU, I know it, whenever you get a permanent job, especially at some level, we feel, theek hai, the job mil gaya, whether we do the work, we don't do the work, it's least bothered. And you're right. At least at some level, they are not even knowing about the accounts. And they feel that unnecessarily our boss is saying this. They even don't follow the order sometimes. I agree to it. That point, and that point is always there.
Sir, almost all the NITs, universities are running short of staff in accounts, proper staff in accounts department. So getting the professional service is very much required. But here we find that proper professional agency, proper professional agency is not available in every city, everywhere. So it is to be defined.
Sir, why I have given a role to ICAI. I come to it. That is the next slide.
Many chartered accountant firms are there who are auditing and getting the regular kind of.
All CAs cannot do this work because this is a typical government experience. And that's the reason, let me come to that slide of CA. I have put it the responsibility there.
And another thing, sir, for assistant and deputy registrar in all universities, NITs, as far as I know, the minimum requirements, essential qualification is post graduation with 55% marks. There is nothing is given, no weightage is given to professional.
I agree.
Sir, I have two suggestions over here.
Please.
One, when online e-filing, I mean return was introduced by Income Tax Department.
TDS.
TDS. There were a TPO way trend across the country. Right? And for this format also, I'm sure that other colleague may agree. Even CAs are not trained, firm are not trained for this particular, even external agencies are not there with us who can prepare our account. One, we are of course not trained, others are also not trained. So we can have a manpower who can prepare the annual account, either external or internal, whatever may be one. Secondly, we should have a strong technological intervention in that. We all agree that technological intervention, we can definitely resolve it.
I have put it the e-software concept.
Either IKAI. IKAI is a regulator. We can have a centralized software either somewhere and we can one can feed the data and get the output.
Sir, MHRD or by some other
agencies.
MHRD has already started that. From IIT Kanpur, only one software presentation was prepared. I come to it. Wo bhi hai. Brihaspati naam hai uska software ka.
No, I'll tell you, telling the things are it's different and practically is different. There should be a strong time limit and the output result should be there. That there should be a centralized software, kind of ERP software. So through which at least everyone can use that software and prepare the accounts.
Okay, I'll put that. I'll come to it already. Yes, sir, please.
In account section in any IIT, there are some problems that doesn't happen with other sections. Like we have to, as a chartered accountant, you can understand we have to file TDS return, service tax return, workers' welfare assess and other all things related formalities. We face two times audit, internal audit, one time CAG audit. We have to spend our lot of time there. But our employers, our management doesn't think that they always think about the ratio which is given by the MHRD that teaching employees and non-teaching employees, these ratios should be maintained. But in case of account section, it is specifically, it should be considered that staff of the account section should have to give time to study the taxation laws, updation in taxation laws, and the procedure which is regularly changed in TDS and other. They don't consider that we have to spend
training mein abhi aap dekh rahe hain MHRD ki responsibility at the institutional level is blank. Let me come to that. Usme already points
hai. They always feel that some person working in establishment or administration section and they are maintaining only leave records. They compare that if 4 person are maintaining all the administration, then why 4 person cannot maintain
the
accounts?
I think let's not discuss about the attitude. I'm telling you, wo, not even you can change, not even I can change. We can only look at the procedural part.
Sir,
I am telling you the attitude part. I have been facing this. You have been facing this.
This time I want to request to Bokshi sir to do something like staff strength should be accessed in account section in comparison to other
sir,
sections.
I am telling you, even Bokshi sir can only present it. Even you know at the government level, it is the hierarchy. And wait for Friday. Ab achhe din aayenge, bure din aayenge, pata nahi hai. But wait for Friday. And how the things will change, you never know. I am telling you that. You look at any point.
Manual for administration and okay. Another manual for accounts. Two separate manuals should be prepared.
Sir, यहाँ पर हम लोग administration की बात नहीं कर रहे हैं हम लोग.
We have to say we have to combine our sir to the accounts manual.
Right.
Okay, sir. So one step we have to go upward.
ठीक है.
Finance Ministry. We have not taken the consideration of the Ministry of the Finance who are being giving us the budget under different heads.
Okay.
We have to be considered.
Why? I didn't understand that. Why Ministry of Finance will be involved here?
Because Ministry of Finance allot us the budget.
Ministry of Finance give the budget to the MHRD
okay.
in different heads. That we have to be considered.
Whatever I know, budget requirement always goes from the bottom.
Okay.
Right? You have to say first of all, yes, yes. and then it gets definitely. Consolidated top.
Even very so many deviation is made by the Ministry of Finance also. So that we have to be followed.
Sir,
whatever the budget they allotted, according to that, the accounts are to be prepared under the
sir,
different
MHRD minor responsibility.
Heads. Yes.
MHRD ki responsibility is that they will have to provide a separate budget for these reforms. They have yeah. to request for a separate budget for the reforms.
Okay.
Wo hoga sir. Wo points pe aa gaya. Because jab tak budget separate nahi hoga, logically even to pay the professional agency, you need a money.
No, there is a separate budget for the ministry. No, the Ministry of Finance allot a separate budget to the MHRD and MHRD again it distribute to the different institutions.
I have
that
only,
is to be followed.
Sir, I have only made a suggestion, a separate budget, maybe a minimal budget,
okay.
only for the reforms.
Budget in different heads, they provide the budget in the different, in plan and non-plan, in tribal, for SC, for SC.
Agreed. Sir, this will be, they may have to create a separate head,
okay.
whatever it is, but there has to be some budget for reforms.
Moreover, we are government autonomous institutions, GFR to be followed, that instructions to be taken.
Sir,
we
already aage, GFR, yes. Sir, jab ministry guidelines issue kar degi, to GFR ka automatically ad jayega.
Yes, GFR.
Most of us are not a part of the decision making here. My humble submission is that we should take up the whatever the topic is for the today, because in otherwise we are going to waste most of the time in discussion and all that, and we can take up all these things
sir,
at the end
sir.
Of it. So the thing is that we can take up the problems, but most of the things which are at the decision making level. So here we can just recommend and just
recommend,
but
I agree.
Sir, hello.
Sorry, exactly right, because at present we are only providing points and there will be a separate, I have provided a solution of training also for the seniors also, training at different levels. Boli sir, boli please.
Just now sir mentioned that there should be two manuals, one for the administration and one for the finance, and you said that we are not discussing, the administration part is not covered here. Practically, there are a number of issues related with finance, like procurement of assets, which is handled by administration. Like we have purchase and inventory control department.
Sir, if you have seen, let me intervene here. If you have seen any manual, that manual always has a section of the procurement also.
No, but
that manual always has it.
But I was trying to make out that. At a substantial part of the information which is required by the finance is to be handled or to be taken from the administration side. So that area has to be somehow covered under the manual. So whether it is one manual or two manual, but
so covered hoga.
Section, yes.
Sir, finance manual mein operational manual word hai. Finance manual word nahi hai.
Ye, ye.
Operational manual means finance se related jitne bhi operations hote hain.
Haan.
वो सब उसे कवर्ड होंगे
एंड मोस्ट ऑफ द डिफिकल्टीज दैट फाइनेंस पीपल आर फेसिंग अ नंबर ऑफ एरियाज आर सच दैट द इंफॉर्मेशन रिक्वायर्ड इज नॉट गेटिंग इज नॉट कमिंग
धीरे धीरे बढ़ेगा ना अभी तो सर स्टार्टिंग से लेट्स नॉट बिकॉज प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड वो जब ऑपरेशन मैनुअल के लिए कंसल्टेंट आएगा आपके पास आपसे पूछेगा सारे इश्यूज
ओके थैंक यू
सर मेरा एक सजेशन है
बोलिए सर
सर DOPT का डिपार्टमेंट है ISTM डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ पर्सनल ट्रेनिंग तो ISTM है इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ सेक्रेटरियल ट्रेनिंग एंड मैनेजमेंट तो वो कोर्स कराते हैं न्यू जॉइनिंग के असिस्टेंट्स के हैं UDC और दूसरे LDC वगैरह के तो इसी तरह के कैश एंड अकाउंट्स का कोर्स है जो अकाउंट्स पर्सन के लिए होता है तो इसको उसमें इंक्लूड करा देना चाहिए सो दैट कि इन फ्यूचर जो है उससे ज़्यादा बेनिफिट मिलेगा
एंड फर्स्ट लेट मी कम्प्लीट द एंटायर पार्ट बिकॉज व्हाट एवर द इश्यूज यू आर रेजिंग ऑल आर बीइंग कवर्ड हियर राइट
ये मैं सप्लीमेंट करता हूँ एक इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ गवर्नमेंट अकाउंटिंग एंड फाइनेंस है उसमें भी करवा सकते हैं NIFM में भी करवा सकते हैं
परफेक्ट आई एग्री टू इट एग्री लेट मी फर्स्ट रन थ्रू द स्लाइड्स सो दैट वी कैन कंप्लीट इट एंड देन आई एम टेलिंग यू योर 90% इश्यूज विल बी कवर्ड हियर देन वी कैन एग्री आई विल ओपन अ ब्लैंक स्लाइड एंड लेट्स पुट इट हियर राइट देन वी हैव टू टेक अ अप्रूवल ऑन द ई बेस्ड सॉफ्टवेयर फॉर द न्यू फॉर्मेट ऑलरेडी MHRD has taken the initiative. Lot two or three workshops have already been conducted. I was also part of one of the workshop in Delhi, whereby the software, the template was introduced. It is being prepared by, I think, IASEI IIT Kanpur. So already that process is going on. So its even URL, etc. was given to me. I have checked it. So even in that presentation, we have made some suggestions. So I hope those suggestions till now might have been covered. If I remember correctly, that was made last year. Sir, Bakshi Sahib, if I remember correctly, last year that was? Last year, April, May or May, it was made. This is the work which you can expect by MHRD to take the initiative at the your level, institution level. At present, I agree it's a common workshop. But of course, they, to handle the separate issues, we can have a regional workshops for separate schools, colleges also. That initiative can be taken by MHRD easily. Apart from training, I have always felt, I have followed this in a lot of my assignments. We always go for the group discussions, focus group discussions with the accounts officers. Let's suppose I'm organizing at one state. In that one state or one city, all the bodies, finance people will come, they will sit together, they will discuss all their issues for one day, point out and list out the issues, and then those issues are being forwarded to the, let's go from city to the state, state to the national, and finally to the ministry. It means, let's suppose, if I'm in Delhi, I'm organizing it. So in Delhi, all the autonomous bodies can organize together. Their finance people can come. They can present their issues for one day, discuss it, find the solutions, not only the problems. Please, giving the problem is very easy. You have to give the solutions also. That even the initiative, maybe the ministry can take it, organize at city level, at the state level, and it's hardly one day workshop. Even half day, you can just sit together, decide ki these are the problems you are facing it, and these can be the possible solution. Jaise sir ne kaha bhi, Jamia se sir hain, ki sir administration bhi hona chahiye. Agreed. Once he comes into discussion, he lists out ki mujhe ye problem aa raha hai. Jaise aapka point aaya ki it should be included in NIFM or Institute of Governance or etc. You can mention in that solution. So apart from the this common workshop, because it's a large group, you never have a concrete solution. Concrete solution always come in one-to-one. So it's always advisable, sir, ki hum city level pe, it's only Delhi we can have for IITs, IIT Delhi is there. We can have the University of Delhi or other institutes. Their finance people can come together, present their problem for one day, and find out the solutions. No external agency is required in that. They can just come and present it. If we can have, let's say, 50 such workshops, 50 such discussions in 50 days, in 50 days, you will have a very good ready reference solution available. And ask one person to compile everything and prepare a solution. Aapka automatically cheez ready rahengi, guaranteed. This is the only time frame from my mindset I prepared, can be changed. In 13, 14, if you see, already the year has gone. When I was discussing with most of you, some of you were saying that we are already preparing the new format. Some of you are also preparing old format because of C&AG. So at present, 13, 14, I'm assuming it's a parallel. You are doing new format because you have to submit to MHRD. You are doing old format because you have to satisfy your auditor. Maybe a Herculean task in 1 year. I know, big task for 1 year. But starting May, hamesha tough hota hai. For 1 year, I agree, tough. But in 14, 15, in this entire 1 year, if MHRD takes some actions, they can have a quarterly workshops at the state level on the new format. Not on once, twice, thrice, four times. Jab teen char bar ek hi workshop hogi, uske issues apne aap nikal ke aayenge. And you guys will be more comfortable then. And don't even wait for the annual statement. Ministry is saying annual, you can even start preparing quarterly first of all. Prepare a quarterly draft as per the new format. Quarterly draft mein itna bade transactions nahi hote hain. Prepare quarterly, bring that quarterly draft in the workshops, in your group discussions, share with each institutes, and then share the problems. That can be a very good solution, sir. If you can have quarterly workshops on the new format, no standards, nothing, on the new format, how to fill it, how to prepare it, because yesterday two or three balance sheets were given to me, I was going through it, they had only one issue, whether it is right, whether it's wrong or not. They mainly wanted to know whatever we have prepared is right or not. It means if you have a quarterly workshop, it can be done. Similarly, this I have added because 13, 14 is gone. CNAG representative, at least at the state level workshop, should be invited. And they never mind. If you send a letter to them, they will be more happy to be there. If they are present in the workshop, they can understand the rationale of these reforms. And if they come, which I have experienced last 2 days, mainly all of us are little bit indifferent towards the reforms because they know they have to satisfy auditor also. If auditor says, relax, I will check your new format, I will not check the old format, I can guarantee most of you will be agreed, ready to go for the new format. If CNAG representative is invited and he also says, fine, I am happy with the solution, I will be more happy if you follow accounting standards, if you follow rules and regulations, my task will be much more easier. And if that report has been prepared by a CA, let's say, or has been checked by a CA, then logically the auditor work is almost half. That is only suggestions. Then of course, agreement on an e-based software, which is very, very important, because manual is tough, and I agree with sir, there has to be some centralized software. It's not that IIT Delhi is following something else, IIT Kanpur is following different. Tough. IIMS is following their own software. Usme guaranteed hai, reporting format will be different. Aur usme sabse major issue tab aata hai, let's suppose I am Calcutta person being transferred to IIM Raipur, I'm assuming it. Then there's an issue. Because then he has to work for the new software again. Yes, sir, Nika sir has worked with ministry also, CBSE also. If you are working in different level and different softwares, again a tough. Again, you have to start from scratch, which I know as a human being and at our age, I know it's very tough. You can learn, you can cram the things by at the age of 20, 25. But after 25, you can learn the new things. To cram is very tough. And that's the reason there has to be one ready solution available. And of course, operational manual is very, very important. If it's possible, it can be easily be prepared within 6 months. Jata mera experience hai, manual never takes more than 6 months. In Kabul, we prepared in 3 months. So 6 months is a good time, and if our manual is ready, you can have a draft manual first of all. Shared with everyone, let the suggestions come, and then a final solution. And the last I prepared, 15-16 financial statement through e-base as per the new format. Or jab already software mein, when software already covers the new format and the training has been given, you have to just go there, feed the data and get the results. Even depreciation rates, etc. will already be there. Like in the income tax software. In income tax software, we never calculate the depreciation. We just put the plant, automatically they calculate it. Similarly, if you have an exhaustive list of universities, state and center, put the depreciation rate there, immediately you can calculate it, not required. So that possibility can be there. I hope this time period is fine or you want to further do this. This is the expectation from ICI front. I'm no one from ICI. Sir.
Workshop, you know, CNAG to invite the company. Then ourselves working, and then CNAG senior level workshop.
Bilkul, sir.
Workshop ka kisi early UD ko bhej diya. यहाँ आया खाना खाया चला गया
सर लोकल ऑडिट ऑफिसर का कोई काम नहीं है एलओए का कोई काम नहीं है
हो इसलिए वर्कशॉप में वैसे लोग आए जो इफेक्टिव हो ये नहीं कि भोजन किए टहले घूमे उसके बाद गए एक रिपोर्ट
सर आई एग्री विद सर इवन व्हाट यू कैन हैव इट वी आर फॉलोइंग इट वी हैव ऑर्गेनाइज्ड वन वर्कशॉप फॉर द लोकल गवर्नमेंट फर्स्ट फॉर द अकाउंट्स देन वी हैव ऑर्गेनाइज्ड वन वर्कशॉप फॉर द कमिश्नर लेवल बिकॉज व्हेन द कमिश्नर लेवल पीपल कम ऑटोमेटिकली द पावर गोज डाउन You can also have one, yes sir, ne ka, we are not the decision making authority. You can have one day workshop only for the senior people, where you're not teaching them, you're telling to them the rationale of the reforms. And logically, when the top management knows it, it automatically comes downwards. So you can have one day workshop for that also. I agree with you. Let me complete this, give me 10-15 minutes, then all discussion only, okay? provide clarification about the applicability, because I know still some of you are not comfortable whether AS are applicable to us or not. Let the regulation or the notification come from the ICI that yes, these AS are applicable to the university or the education institute also. And CA can, ICI can give you the list that these are the AS relevant. I have prepared at least also. Then, as they are doing it right now, support to MHRD in giving the trainings. Because again, these trainings are very, very different. It's not like a commercial or private training. Because in this training, only that people can suffice who has the government knowledge. Person having the private sector background will never be able to do justice here. This, which you guys were mentioning, ICI can create one regional accounting cell. ICI at present has the 5 regional councils. NIRC, Southern, Eastern, Western, Central. This is just a suggestion from my side, maybe ICI follow or not, but it's from my mind. If they create one regional accounting cell from their office itself, there is a committee called PDC, Professional Development Committee. There is also one committee, Committee on Public Finance and Government Accounting. If that committee can create an accounting cell at all the regional levels, let's suppose at the Western level, anyone in the Western region, maybe IIT Bombay, they could immediately refer their problem to Western region. Sir, we are facing this problem in the implementation. So immediately a solution will be given to you. And solution given by ICI, no one questions, I'm telling you. Not even an auditor questions it. So if that accounting cell, like a call center, like a health center, if it can be created, tell me, will it help or not? Yes or no? Yes. So it's just from my side, let me see whether it can be implemented or not, but I'm sure generally wo follow karte hain. Then these are the some standards which I have listed out of 31, which sir, might be relevant to different organizations.
Sir, going back to that implementation, you have mentioned that 2013-14 parallelly 2 accounts to be prepared.
It is for those organizations. In the last 2 days, they mentioned to me that already they are preparing at the old format also, reason of the auditor.
Okay.
And they are preparing the new format also because of the MHRD.
This year actually what we have to do it, sir, since this year whether we have to prepare in new format or in old format?
That will take it the last. What to do will take it the last.
Okay.
At the last.
Okay.
Now, yesterday our AS13 was not covered, but AS13, frankly speaking, when I was going through the annual report, all of you are following almost right. Because as per AS13, it talks about the investment.
My suggestion is that in accounts department, in any organization, let it be IIT, IIM or CBSE or any other department, persons who are not knowing accounts are also posted in the account section. At the time of recruitment also, newcomers are given. They are also posted in the account section.
Right,
there is no induction training at all. So my suggestion is that why can't we make a course which is required to be completed by the person. It may be 3 days course or 5 days course or 7 days course. They have to undergo this course conducted by ICI. It need not to be a qualifying kind of thing, but they have to undergo this course and they get the, awareness about the accounting standards which are to be implemented. I think it will help it will go a long way and it will sit right.
I agree, ma'am. Ma'am agreed, but until unless... I agree. There are always two types of training, off the job, on the job.
Yeah,
right.
It can be induction.
Off the job has to be at least one day only, then you can go for on the job. At least one day off the job has to be there, ma'am.
Present,
otherwise, on the job is not possible.
Presently, what happens, if the staff which are posted to the account section, they will not be knowing accounts. If they do not succeed in any of the department, they are shunted to the accounts department. In most of the institute, this is my experience, I am telling you. Based on my experience, I am telling you. Because what they perceive, they think that accounts department has to do nothing. They have to add 2 plus 2, it becomes 4. And they have to just pass the bills. So we get the kind of stuff which are not, performing in other sections or other departments, those kind of staff are posted in the accounts department, and then we expect accounting standards to be implemented. So there should be a condition that the person should have that certificate. Then only he can be posted in the accounts department.
Like in schools, they have done it for the CTT exam.
Yeah.
Yes.
And then the persons who are posted in the accounts department, they remain under the control of the finance officer. Because if there is a rift, immediately they are, shunted. If the person is not, performing as per the expectation of other senior officers and creating problems, they are perceived that they are the challenges. So they are removed.
Chalisa, sir, done. I'll take first investment. Investments are always two types. Everyone knows it, current and long term. Current investment is up to 12 months. Please understand, if you see AS13, that was a question which was asked to me yesterday. So how we decide whether it is current or long term? If you see the AS13, it very clearly says, if the organization intends to dispose of within 12 months, then it is current. It means, I am assuming it. Let's suppose in February, I have purchased some shares in February. And I am saying, no, I will not sell it at least for 2 years. It means in the month of March, February and March, 2 months, still one year has not gone by. My accountant will ask me, they will ask management, tell us this investment you have made, whether you are keeping till 1 year or more than 1 year. Whether 1 year has gone by or not, irrelevant. The word in AS is very clear, intend, intention. So, if February, I know, let's suppose in month of February, I have purchased some capital gain bonds. Everyone knows it. And capital gain bonds, you cannot redeem before 3 years. Even though I have purchased in February, it's a long term. Let's suppose in the month of February, I have opened a fixed deposit in a bank to claim ATC deduction. That tax deduction FD, you cannot redeem before 5 years. Aapne kara February mein. Aapne kara February mein. Sir, FD tax deduction ke liye jo hota hai, wo 5 saal se pehle nikalta nahi hai. Agar aapne, if you have deposited FD in the month of February to claim ATC, so even though 2 months, still it is a long term. And AS is sabse easy AS hai, kuch hai nahi iske andar. Current investment is always valued at cost price or the fair value or the market value, whichever is lower. But in most of the institutions, when I was going through the annual report, aapke mein mainly investment ye hai. Am I right? Mainly, I'm not saying exhaustive list hai ye. Basically, aapka PF ka jo paisa aata hai, wo aap invest karte hai. NPS ka hai. In some annual report, it was written that some money is invested in shares also, in debenture and bonds. Yes. Sir, I have seen the annual report with me. I want to understand. I don't know kaise ho raha hai ye. Mujhe sure nahi. Because PF mein likha hua tha 5% wala pehle. Am I right, sir? Right? PF mein guidelines hai up to, I think, maximum 5%. You can invest in shares. And that decision has to be taken by the management. Correct me. Mera feel nahi hai, but generally, when I was going through the annual report, to wo allowed hai. सर आप क्या करते हैं
गवर्नमेंट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में सबसे बड़ा डर है कि ये हो जाए वो हो जाए वी ऑलवेज अवॉइड शेयर्स
सर आप मैं एग्जांपल लेता हूं मुझे आई एम रियली स्केयर्ड अबाउट दी बिग स्विंग्स बट माय वाइफ एंजॉयज इट माय किड्स एंजॉयज इट तो फियर इज अ रिलेटिव टर्म
इफ समथिंग हैपेंस Then in that case, government is not going to spare.
Agreed, government will not compensate. Guideline mein permissible hai sir. Jitna mujhe guideline sab PF ka pata hai, usme likha hua hai.
Wo to hai, permitted.
And sir, please, it's not necessary that shares, you always invest in a risky shares. Shares different bhi hote hain. As a debenture bonds. How many of you have invested in debenture and bonds? But debenture bonds bhi risky nahi hai. Usme bhi sir, aajkal Balance funds aate hain, or balance funds you can invest it. So that was a type of investment mainly. From institute, now comes to you guys. Earlier it was very, very easy. Yes, MHRD, ICI, now let's see from your side. Get the acceptances of the management, and that will be done in coordination with MHRD. They have to organize one training of your seniors, and they have to agree that yes, these reforms are required. Because I know once you go to the real life, senior always says, forget about the reform first. First, talk about the day. This is in the day you have to go by the report. First, complete that. I know that. Then comes, there's always one common word, resistance to change. I know it's very tough. Whenever you want to change it, there's always the agitation, resistance, always there.
Particularly, it is very difficult in older university. New university has no problem.
But sir, we are needing it. But sir, wo spirit chahiye. And people will learn from you. If you say, yes, the reforms are required, I'm telling you, the juniors will immediately say, yes, when you can do it, why we can't do it? So until that spirit is there, I'm telling you, nothing can be achieved. Nothing can be achieved. Team spirit is a major part. Without that, nothing can be achieved. This, we have already discussed it. And I'm not saying permanent external agency. I'm only saying contractual. When you feel that you have become self-sustainable, ask them to leave. Ask them to leave immediately. Because please understand, the ma'am rightly said, if you depend upon that, then it's not good for you. It will make you handicapped. You have to bring that drive. Yes, now I am self-sufficient, self-sustainable. I don't need any external help. Please go. Oh, and I'm telling you, if especially for all the youngsters, if you start developing that drive, if you start developing a drive to learn, this is the limit. You take my example. I'll just take 2 minutes. I was a permanent faculty in the University of Delhi. I could have enjoyed my life just taking 2 lectures daily and getting a salary above 1 lakh. I resigned from that job. Many of my seniors told me, why you're resigning, you can take a leave, etc. I said, no. If I take a leave, then my mind will be at 2 places. I resigned it. At present, in ICI, there's a director of Board of Studies, Mr. Vijay Kapoor. He was the permanent faculty in UC Delhi. He resigned. He went to ICI, and now he's at the director level. So if you want to learn and if you want to reach at the sky level, I'm telling you, there's no limit. And I'm impressed at our Ministry of Urban Development. There is one Undersecretary, Sanjay Sharma. He's 50 plus. And he is at present doing MBA from Sikkim, Manipal. He says, after this project gets complete in which I am involved, he says, I will leave the government job, I'll look for the consulting. So if you take these reforms, I'm telling you, these reforms, especially for the youngsters, are very, very good. You can have a sky as a limit for your jobs and for your career. There are two attitudes. One, yes, we have got a government job, very good, let's relax. Other is, if you want to achieve and drive it, sky is the limit, I'm telling you. Yes, sir.
What I perceive, implementation of AS is having a good business projection, in fact. Can we tell market to sell the solution?
Sir, bataiye. Bakshi sahab will be giving the answer to this.
Sir, what I'm telling, actually, there are a number of central organizations, NIT, IIT, IIM, Central Universities, KB, NVS, and other there. Implementation of AS and new format annual account, having a good business projection, very good business projections.
Okay, welcome.
So, can we tell market to sell the solutions?
Okay, business prospect, market will automatically come.
Sir, I'm ready. You can invite me anytime. I'm ready.
So, you have got the reply.
Any training at IIM, etc. you want for the reforms, accounting standards, Pankaj Goel is always there for the government advisory. Then you are right. You are right. See, this initiative can be taken. It's a very good suggestion. This initiative, I'll take an example. It's a very good suggestion. When in 2009, in India, IFRS, International Financial Reporting Standard, word came. You won't believe it, in 1 year, lot of institutes, you will agree, sir, in IIMs, etc., there were a lot of courses were designed. 1 week, 2 week, 3 week courses. And all the professors minted the money like anything. Minted money, I'm telling you. That's the reason I'm saying to you. any institute of out of you which transforms the new format first time will create a template for everyone, an example for everyone, and people will invite you. Let's suppose University of Allahabad or IIT Delhi or IIM Calcutta, let's say, implement for the first time. Then people will invite you as a speaker. Please tell us. Please share your solutions. Please share your problems. It's a good business solution, I'm telling you. You're right. That's the reason I made that point. That's only the mindset. If you can see that business coming up, huge money and huge appreciation in the market. First is, of course, I expect all your institutes to create one accounting cell headed by maybe a nodal officer, having the finance officer as the nodal officer, and under them, they are working the accounts people. We have followed this in all the local government, and it's coming out as a good solution. Because when from central ministry any person goes, they never contact anyone, they contact nodal officer, and then they go for a half-day workshop, half-day interaction. The nodal officer is informed, this person from ministry is coming. Immediately, nodal officer has to organize a workshop for 1 hour, for interaction 1 hour. What is the status? Immediately. In that, external agency is there. I'll take an example in Bhopal. I'm taking real life example. In Bhopal, there's a project going on MPIUADP, Madhya Pradesh Urban Infrastructure. Already, it's a DFID, UK funded. Bhopal government is there. Consultants are there, right? Still, they have appointed me. They ask me to come there every month to review the balance sheet. It means at least they are getting a external help also. Consultant is there, funding is there. So, wo hamesha benefit hai. Or it's the starting 1 year, 2 years. If you have starting 1 year, 2 years, reforms automatically gets implemented. So, kindly, once you go there, at least try to create a group. Like we create a Google group or Facebook group, and I'll advise everyone, if you can follow, try to utilize this platform. Please create one Google platform. Everyone gets a member of that. Maybe a Facebook page, accounting reforms, yeah, accounting standards, and let's have a chat or sessions daily basis. We don't mind. That initiative, MHRD will not take it. Any one of you can take it. And it will really, I'm telling you, will help everyone. And of course, this is very important, easy access to the resources, because when the consultant, anyone comes, documents you have to provide. Sometimes when a consultant comes on the outside, it is very tough to get the documents ready. That you have to give it. So I'm hoping for this. Do you agree? C&AG, ICI, MHRD, you guys, if we jointly bring the hands together, then guaranteed we can have a financial statements as per the new format or as per the accounting. So we need a coordinated effort, not a single effort, I'm telling you. Single effort se koi jeeta nahi, no one wins it. So I hope to continue this after the break.